In this Blender tutorial, I'm going to show you how to put any 3D model in any 2D photograph. Then we can use lighting from the 2D photograph with a 3D model and perfectly place it with perspective and shadows within that scene from that 2D photograph. We're going to use a tool called fSpy. You can go ahead and download fSpy. Open an image in fSpy that you want to put your 3D model in. I'm going to quickly go through this, and I have a more in-depth tutorial about using fSpy linked in the description. First, I need to think about how this image is arranged. In this particular image, I think that using one-point perspective is going to be much better. So I'll go ahead and line these up with one-point perspective. I can hold Shift to zoom in. Then I'll line these guides up with the floor right here. And this will allow me to then tell Blender where the perspective for this is. Once again, hold Shift to zoom in, and I have a pretty good one-point perspective. I can move this cursor around to check to see how that's looking. You can see that it's a little off here, so this tile may not be perfectly aligned with the floor. If that's the case, I can go ahead and try to use the floor as my guide instead. So I'll click right there, then I'll move over here to this. Now I can check again to see how that lines up. Still lines up over here. Lines up pretty well. Yeah, it looks like the tile may not be perfectly square to the floor, but the ceiling lines up. We care about the room more than anything else. So this looks pretty good. One thing we can do is set where the origin is. I'm going to go ahead and set the origin, I think, right here, because then I can kind of guess how tall that door is. Over in the reference distance, if I select along the Z-axis, then I can type in how long I think that is. And this is probably something around 2 meters, since it's an elevator doorway, maybe a little bit taller. So I'll type 2. And now I have a scale for the Blender scene. I'll go ahead and save this. Inside Blender, I'll press A to select everything, X, delete. If you don't have the fSpy Blender add-on, you need to install it. I have a video showing how to install it linked in the description. Then go to File, Import, fSpy. Navigate to where you have your fSpy photo, then import the fSpy project file. Here we can see that we have the photo as a background image to a special camera that is perfectly aligned with this photo. Our origin point is also right here at the lower corner. If I press Shift A to create a plane, it starts at the origin. I can tab into edit mode, press 2 for edge mode, press G to grab, then along the Y axis, and I can move it over to this wall. And notice how it stays in perspective. I can move this edge as well, G then Y. I can move this back, G X, all the way to the end there. And I can move G X this way. I can go all the way past. Maybe I'll move this one, G Y, over just a little bit. It doesn't have to be perfect, but we do want it accurate enough that we can get some geometry. If I press Control R, then I can add some edge loops right here for these doorways. So I'll add one right here, Control R, another one right here, a couple more edge loops. We don't need everything, but we want some of this geometry so it helps with the reflections in our composite. I'll press E to extrude and then go along the Y axis. I'm gonna go ahead and go all the way over to the outside of the photograph. Then I'll extrude again, EY. This time I'll only go to where the door is, then EY. This is a pretty good approximation of the floor. There are plenty of more details we could potentially add, but this is great. Now I need to create the walls and the ceiling. I think the easiest way to do this is to select 3, and I'll select all of these faces of the floor. So now I'll press E to extrude, but it's kind of hard for me to see where I'm extruding to. So I'm going to go ahead and undo that. Then I'll click on the camera, switch to object mode, click on the camera icon down here. Then under background images, I can move the image to the front. And then I can change its opacity. So if I keep the opacity at about 50%, then I click the mesh again, tab back into edit mode, press 3 to select these faces. Now when I press extrude, I can kind of see where I'm extruding to. So that works a little bit better. If you still can't see because of this front face, I can press 3, then press X, delete this face. And now I can see inside the cube. I still need to adjust these, so I'm going to press 3, and I'll select each of these faces here. Switch back to the camera view. then G, Z to move this up and down. Now remember that this is not a perfect perspective match because it sounds like the tile and the walls are not perfectly square, but this will be plenty good for our lighting and composition. So the only last thing I could potentially add is put an edge loop right here, and then I can punch that ceiling up. Many ways to do this. I think I'll go ahead and grab these three ceiling tiles right here by holding shift. Then I'll go back to the camera view, press E, Z, and just move those up. So now I have this nice ceiling thing. This is enough for us to complete our composite. I might move this edge right here since it's not grabbing the entire photograph. So I'll orbit around, press 2 for edge mode, select all of these edges, G, move them in the X direction, press 1 to grab this vertex, G, X, control, lock that right there. So now we are ready to move back into object mode, and now we can project the textures from this photograph onto our model, and then use everything to light our scene. To project the textures, we need to add a material to this object. So in order to do that, I'll go ahead and click on materials. Now click new material. I'll label this material reflections. And instead of a principal BSDF, I'm going to use an emission shader. Then for the color, click this yellow dot, and we want an image texture. And we're going to open the image that we used for our photo match. Navigate to where you have your image and open the image. We don't see anything yet, but if we switch to material preview, we'll see that our image is splattered kind of all over the model, and it doesn't look so good. That's because we need to UV project based on our camera. Make sure you have the mesh selected. Click on modifiers. We'll go ahead and add a generate subdivision surface. You can see this gets all messed up because we don't have any bevels. So go ahead and click simple, then increase the subdivisions up to 6. We'll add one more modifier under edit, UV project. For the UV map, select the default UV map. And then for the object, select the fSpy camera. So we're starting to look better here, but there's still some things that we need to do. For example, the aspect ratio right now is 1:1. We need to find out the aspect ratio of the original image. Then in Blender, under the UV project, I can paste in that resolution. It's 4,032 by 2,268. If I put that in, now we can orbit around and we can see that yes, outside of the object, there's all this messed up stuff. If we don't want to see that, we can go ahead and click on the image texture. And right here where it says repeat, we can change that to clip. We can also eliminate the black, but for our purposes of making a composite image with a sculpture, we don't need to do that. As you can see, we get a little bit of 3D space and everything is projected well. It looks perfect from the camera view. Remember, we are no longer looking at the photograph. We are looking at 3D geometry that has the photograph projected onto it. Let's go ahead and add something that we can use as a sculpture. I'll press Shift A, add a mesh, and we'll go ahead and add Suzanne the monkey. I'll press G, Shift Z to move the monkey, R to rotate, R, Z to have it move towards us. Remember that we can move around and I can look perfectly in the X direction, press G, Z, and then move that up so it's sitting right there on the floor. Go back to the camera view, and we can see it is there. Press G, X, and I can move it. And remember, everything is moving in space, in perspective. I'm going to go ahead and move the image to the back. Click on the fSpy camera, then in the background image, put it to the back. So now we can see our model again. And this really shows you that this image texture is in front. Click on Suzanne. Let's add a modifier, generate subdivision surface. We'll add a couple subdivisions. Also add a material, new material. We'll call this material shiny monkey. Under metallic, increase the metallic to 1 and the roughness to 0. And you can see that we have all these trees reflecting on our monkey. We can see that even better if we shade smooth. But look, there's no trees in our hotel lobby. So why isn't it reflecting the hotel lobby? That's because we're still on material preview. If we select render preview, suddenly we have no reflections. That's because we're using the default EV renderer. Click on the camera change the render to cycles, and suddenly now you can see that the lobby is reflecting the floor, the walls, and everything else, just as if the monkey was really there in the 3D scene. If I look through the camera and I press RZ, as I rotate the monkey, you can see that the reflections truly are coming from the different objects. If I move the monkey to the back or closer to this light, notice how this light is reflecting on the monkey. So this is a great technique when you're trying to composite a 3D model into a 2D image and make it look realistic. I'll press G, Shift Z to move the monkey up to here. Maybe right there looks good. This is going to be a wonderful sculpture inside the hotel. Now, probably a good idea to go ahead and add maybe an interior HDRI image just to kind of fill out the area so we get just a few more lights and things like that, just a generic lighting scheme rather than just the lighting from these reflections. To add an HDRI image, click the World tab, then click the color, select Environment Texture. Now we can see all these yellow highlights that are coming in from the HDRI that's not there. The best place to get HDRIs is Polyhaven. In a web browser, go ahead and navigate to Polyhaven, select Indoor, then we'll go ahead and select something that is low contrast, something that just doesn't have a lot going on. In fact, the Polyhaven Studio looks like it's pretty good. It's got these can lights. I'm going to go ahead and select that. A 2K image is plenty for what we need, just general ambient lighting. I'll download the image. Back in Blender, under the Environment Texture, click Open. Navigate to where you downloaded the HDRI image from Polyhaven. Here I have it right here. Open the image. Now you can see that we have a bit more light reflecting on different parts of the image that may have been dark. We can rotate this image depending on how we want it to be in our scene. Now we have the HDRI image casting light, but we really don't notice any change. That's because the walls and the ceiling are acting as blockers. They're not letting the light into the monkey. Select the mesh, tab into edit mode, and I'm going to orbit so I can select all the bottom planes. Press 3 for face mode and select all the ground floor planes. Once you are sure that you have all of the floors selected, go ahead and right click separate by selection. Now we have the floor as a separate object because we're going to use the floor as a shadow catcher. Press tab to go to object mode and select the walls. Once you have the walls selected, we're going to change their visibility. In the object properties, scroll down to visibility, deselect camera, so now they're no longer visible, and deselect shadow. Now they'll no longer cast a shadow, and if I look through the camera, and if you want to see what it looks like, I can still see them in the camera, but now they're not casting a shadow, so we have more light coming through that HDRI image for the monkey. Next, select the ground plane, and we're going to turn that into a shadow catcher. This will make it disappear because that's what a shadow catcher does, but notice we don't see any shadow. That's because it's still an emission texture. On the ground, and we can label this shadow ground, click on the material, then we can click this button to duplicate it. So now this is reflections 2, and we'll call it shadow. Select the shading tab. Then under the nodes, instead of an emission shader, you can select it, press X to delete, press Shift A, search, and type diffuse. If I select diffuse, I can place it right here, attach the color from the texture, and then attach this to the surface. And now we have a diffuse texture that will accept shadows. Let's go back to layout and look through our camera. So now you can see that it's collecting these shadows from the light. We're just about ready to start compositing our image. First, click on the Compositing tab, and then select Use Nodes. Can't see anything here, so we need to add a viewer node. Press Shift A, search, and then type Viewer. Select Viewer and place it. We can take the output from the render layers and plug it into the viewer node. We still don't see anything, so let's go ahead and render an image. Now we have the image rendered, but we're looking at the Polyhaven Studio. We have the reflections from our hotel lobby, but how do we get the image to be there with the shadow and the reflections? We use the compositor in Blender to add a background image. I'll close the render tab, then press Shift A, search, and we're going to use image. Then we'll open an image, select the same image you used in fSpy. Now we need one more node to be able to see the image rather than the Polyhaven Studio. Press Shift A, then search for alpha over. Place alpha over into your compositor. Then the image goes on the top level, and then the render layers go onto the bottom. Go ahead and take the output from alpha over into the composite. And there's one last thing to do. Click on the render tab, scroll down to film. In order to see the alpha channel, we need to select transparent. Now go ahead and render an image. So now we have everything composited. We still get the reflections from the 3D geometry, yet we have shadows on the ground. Perhaps this shadow could be a little stronger, so you could increase the intensity of the emission on the ceiling, or even add a light to intensely give a shadow right there. And we could also add some ambient inclusion down at the bottom. But hopefully this allows you to composite any 3D model into any 2D image inside of Blender and have a really nice, realistic composite. Happy 3D modeling.